get these bucks. You got eczema.
I got what?
The eczema.
Hey guys, Mr. T. Laxify back, and in today's video I'm coming at you guys with another zombies video, and in this one, this is going to be the top 5 satisfying moments in Call of Duty Zombies. Now I want to stress something clear in today's list: this is the stuff that doesn't happen too often, but when it does, it's just woo! It just makes you feel great, guys. It's probably one of the best things. So anyways guys, let's head on straight into our number 5 spot. And in today's video, this is going to be the Panzer glitch on Origins. Now, oh my goodness, this reminds me of the challenge that I did with the Smith Plays, and it was on the reverse rainbow perk challenge, getting all the perks backwards in the reverse rainbow order, and we were so lucky to actually get the Panzer stuck in this sort of wall. I don't really know how it worked, I don't really know how we did it, but we somehow managed to do it, and it was absolutely crazy. I also have gameplay of the Panzer Soul that just kind of standing in one spot, kind of looking like an absolute idiot. But when this happens, it is such a godsend. It rarely happens, but when it does, it is absolutely amazing, because this means as long as the Panzer is glitched and you don't kill it, more Panzers will not spawn in whatsoever, and it's probably the greatest thing about this. And also for the number 5 spot, we have the Reverse Rainbow Perk Challenge. Now, in my personal opinion, this challenge is definitely the hardest challenge on any zombies game to date. It's getting all the perks on Origins from the reverse rainbow order, basically getting Juggernaut last when you have all 9 perks. It is absolutely ridiculously hard, and it is super duper crazy. If you want to check one out that me and Patrick did, go check it out. It's on my channel. You can go check it out. But anyways, let's get down to our number 4 spot. And in today's video, this is going to be building all the staff solo. Now, man, especially for the Easter egg on Origins, this is a pain in the ass. And this is pretty much the whole Easter egg in itself. And this is not just building all the staffs, but also upgrading all the staffs. Now, it just takes so goddamn long to do all of them. But when you finally finish, it is just woo! You know, you just get that absolutely great feeling. It's unbelievable. I also hate, though, like, when you're building the staffs and you just, like, mess up a step or whatever, or you forget something, then you gotta pause the game, you gotta go on the internet, you gotta look the shit up and everything, and it's just, it takes so much time, but once you finally finish it, it is probably one of the greatest moments out there. And also, if you manage to die while you're doing this and you have to restart the game, it's just, whoa, it's just, whoa, it's just hot! But anyways, guys, let's head on straight into our number 3 spot. And in today's video, this is going to be the fag friend who gets all the good shit. And let me tell you guys, so this is, yeah, that guy you play with. He's good at zombies, but he's a really big faggot. Like, you know, he's just prideful, he boasts about everything. So for example, let's take this on Origins again. So this is the guy, okay, this is the guy that gets the freaking ice staff upgraded. He gets all the good shit. He gets the Mark II upgraded, he gets the Thunder Fist. He doesn't get this all by himself, and he's always prideful and boastful. He's like, oh my god, I got the Rega Mark II. He gets all the shit, right? He gets Mule Kick, he gets all 9 perks. But that moment when this faggot goes down, oh, it is the greatest moment. It is the greatest moment. It's just absolutely amazing, because this guy, you just hate his guts. You just want him to burn. And when he downs, it's just like, yes, yes, finally this guy is down. And obviously you don't pick him up, and, or you tell your friends to pick him up, and then they don't pick him up, and then he rage quits the game. Love that moment, guys. That moment is definitely something to live for. But anyways, guys, let's head out straight into our number 2 spot. And in today's video, this is going to be finishing a hard Easter egg. Now, oh my goodness, you guys have no idea. If you haven't done the buried Easter egg, for example, or the Shangri-La Easter egg, you have no idea the struggles that it takes, especially if you have a not so good team or not so communicative team. We got like two people just like arguing all the time, or someone keeps talking and it's just, oh, it's horrible, guys. Especially the Shangri-La one. You need so much communication in that Easter egg. It's unbelievable. And I understand that like there's a lot of achievement hunters out there that really like doing this stuff, but even for the gamer score, I don't think these two Easter eggs are really, really worth it. And especially for the fact that you really need all four players to be well versed in zombies and to pretty much know the Easter egg. And especially if you got some pretty dumb friends out there, like this is an absolutely crazy satisfying moment when, like, for example, on the Shangri-La one, you get that meteor, right? And you're just like, yes, I did it. I'm finally done. Or I'm buried when you do the freaking shooting range and it's just, oh, it's unbelievable the feeling that you get when you get all those perks and you can even down and still keep those perks. It is definitely one of the greatest feelings. You don't really feel this too much on other maps like Call of the Dead or even Moon, for example. Moon had a pretty hard one, but Buried and Shangri-La, when you beat those Easter eggs on those two maps, it's just woo! It was just woo! It's just great, guys. I love it. But anyways, guys, let's head on straight into our number one spot. And in today's video, this is going to be the classic clutching out the round. Now, oh man, I could give you so many scenarios for this one, but my personal favorite, okay, is when it's like round 40, okay? You're playing with like three other guys. It's a four-player match. Then one guy goes down, the second guy goes down, and the third guy goes down. Or even in grief, this is a great feeling because if you clutch out the round, you basically win the game. It's even a greater feeling. But like when you're the last one alive and you've got barely anything and you're just zooming around the zombies, you're just like whoa, 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 whoa. Like you're just doing whatever you need to do to get out of those hard spots. It is one of the greatest feelings, especially when the zombies just get you in a corner and you do some voodoo magic to get out of those corners. You like zip through their shoulders and you're just whoa, whoa, you fly over them, and it's just it's just the greatest feeling, especially when you got your friends cheering you on. It's just yes, it's just unbelievable. If you guys have never experienced the number one spot, it is definitely the most satisfying moment in zombies, the best moment of gratification you can get in this goddamn game mode. But anyways, guys, I do hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to drop a like. Let's see if we can hit 2500 likes for the next zombies video. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you in the next one.